Praise be to thee, most supreme God, omnipotent, omnipresent, all-pervading, the only being. Take us in thy parental arms, raise us from the denseness of the earth. Thy beauty do we worship, to thee do we give willing surrender. Most merciful and compassionate God, the idealized Lord of the whole humanity, thee only do we worship, and toward thee alone we aspire. Open our hearts toward thy beauty. Illuminate our souls with divine light. O thou, the perfection of love, harmony, and beauty, all-powerful creator, sustainer, judge, and forgiver of our shortcomings, Lord God of the east and of the west, of the worlds above and below, and of the seen and unseen beings, pour upon us thy love and thy light. Give sustenance to our bodies, hearts, and souls. Use us for the purpose that thy wisdom chooseth, and guide us on the path of thine own goodness. Draw us closer to thee every moment of our life, until in us be reflected thy grace, thy glory, thy wisdom, thy joy, and thy peace. Amen. Amen. O thou, who art the perfection of love, harmony, and beauty, the Lord of heaven and earth, open our hearts that we may hear thy voice, which constantly cometh from within. Disclose to us thy divine light, which is hidden in our souls, that we may know and understand life better. Most merciful and compassionate God, give us thy great goodness, teach us thy loving forgiveness, raise us above the distinctions and differences which divide us. Send us the peace of thy divine spirit and unite us all in thy perfect being. Amen. 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 Ya Arhamar Rahimeen. Ya Arhamar Rahimeen. Ya Arhamar Rahimeen. Ya Rabb al-Alameen. Let us reflect tonight on the prayer of At-Tawwab al-Rahim. I think we haven't meditated on this prayer yet. We have meditated on Al-Ghafoor al-Rahim, Al-Aziz al-Rahim. I don't think we have meditated on At-Tawwab al-Rahim. At-Tawwab comes from the verb Taba. Taba is a derived from the verb Aba. Aba means to return, to go back, to take the way back. Aba, al-awwab. Al-awwab is the one who keeps coming back. At-tawwab is the one who gives the chances. Gives a chance for someone to come back. That's what at-tawwab is. So we say the human being taba. We say God tab, Allah yatubu ala al-nas, wa al-nas yatubuna ila Allah. It's one verb that could be used for Allah and could be used for the human at the same time. How is that possible? Because Allah yatubu alayk when He gives you a chance. He gives you a chance to come back. He shows you the way of the return. He gives you another opportunity. He gives you a sabab. Sabab means rope. Sabab in ila sama means rope. He gives you a sabab. Yalla, come back. You are lost. He gives you a sabab, a means, an opportunity. He throws to you a rope of hope, and then to pull you to His rahmah, in His rahmah again. Al-insan yatubu, the human being yatubu as well. Basically, same meaning. He gives himself a chance. Allah will give you a chance, but you need to give yourself that chance, to take the chance that God is giving you. Allah gives you a chance. Allah gives you a chance. But still, you need to give yourself the chance, a chance, to take that chance. Allah gives you an opportunity. يتوب عليك. Reaches to you. Gives you the tawbah. Give yourself a chance. So someone in the مثل الأعلى, the parable, someone is lost and drowning in the sea. And the helicopter are throwing, they throw to him a rope, a ladder. They're giving him a chance. Is that enough? Is he going to be safe? Is that enough? What's next? He needs to catch that chance. He needs to give himself a chance. Allah gives you a chance. He's tawwab. He keeps returning, off-returning. That's how commonly it is translated. The tawwab is the off-returning, right? The off-returning. He keeps returning to you. Why we say off-returning to you? Because it's, again, say Asma Allah al-Husna, it's in the world of the imagination. They are in tashbih here. All the Asma, except Allah, the other Asma are in tashbih, comparison, images, so you can actually taste and see it. So returning, basically, you know the caravan, when you are traveling in a caravan, if you sleep, fall asleep, they rest from time to time. Travel in a caravan and from time to time they take a rest. You take a rest, they tell you don't go far. Yet you go far. You get distracted with gazelles, with things like that, or you sleep, you fall asleep. And then the caravan takes on. They're not going to wait for you. You wake up, you find yourself in the wilderness by yourself. You are literally looking for a tawwab. They call him a tawwab, the person. It's a role in the caravan. They call that person a tawwab. It's the person who keeps returning back to check. Have they lost someone? Have they left someone behind? Have they left something back? You know the story, some of you maybe know the story of Sayyidah Aisha alayhi salam. At some point she was left behind by the caravan and the whole drama happened after that. Drama, tragedy, but also it was an opportunity. It was a shaking for Muslims to learn what is actually azim and what is actually hayyin. Anyways, that story, those who do not know it, can read about it. But the tawwab is, we said, the person who comes back, always who keeps coming back, who keeps returning, off returning, gives you a chance, doesn't leave you, doesn't abandon you, never abandons you. And we are called to imagine our spiritual journey as a journey with the spirit of guidance. The spirit of guidance, or the spirit of God, if you want. As we are traveling, ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim, we are traveling, and following the footsteps, and we are traveling with God. We are traveling on the path of God, we are traveling. And then, from time to time, we get stubborn, we get distracted, we lose our way. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us a chance, comes back to us, puts us back on the path again. That's what a tawwab is. And He sends you tawwabin. He sends you tawwabin. He sends you people who will also catch you. They are a translation or a transmission as well, translation and a transmission of His function, of the function of God or of the nature of God, a tawwab. The off-returning, He will never leave you, abandon you. Now you need to be tawwab, you as well, to catch every time you lose your way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you a chance, you need to take that chance. Allah gives an opportunity, you need to seize that opportunity, catch that opportunity. So we understand now the word at-tawwab. At-tawwab is mubalagha as well. It's not just at-ta'ib. At-ta'ib, it's one time. At-tawwab, it's like again and again and again and yet again, again and yet again. There is a knower of God called Maulana Jalaluddin Rumi, most of you are familiar with. And actually, it was on the wall of Masjid al-Rawdah, on the other side. There is this big, it's like a prayer mat, or, but it's written on it a poetry, like a door and written on it poetry. And it says, come, come, whoever you are. Come, come, whoever you are. And at some point, he tells you, come, yet again, come. Come even if you have broken your vows 1,000 times. Our caravan is not a caravan of despair. Why? Because it is a caravan of tawabin. Come, be tawab, you. Tub. Come back. That's what it is. Come, come. Come whoever you are. Come. Come whoever you are, and come wherever you are, and come whatever you have done. Come whoever you are. Worshipper, wanderer. Come whoever you are. Lover of living, come whoever you are. Sinner, come whoever you are. Muslim, Christian, Jew, come whoever you are. Come from where you are. Say, Ya Allah, where are you at? In a bar, in a mosque, come wherever you are as well. Come, whoever you are and from wherever you are and from any point you are at, come. Come even if you have broken your vows 1,000 times, he says. Our caravan is not a caravan of despair. We don't leave anyone behind. So, absolutely, if any human being tells you this, it's a claim, it's a wish, it's a prayer, but no human being can tell you that really 100% and can actually respect that, because it's not in the capacity of the human being, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one. He is At-Tawwab and He is also Ar-Rahim. These names are paired together. At-Tawwab, Ar-Rahim. He is Ar-Rahim, means the one who is closer to you than your father and mother and brother and sister. Because father, mother, brother, and sister are called Rahim. Ar-Rahim is the one who is even closer to you than your Rahim. That's what Rahim is. The one who is closer to you than your Rahim. So, often translated as merciful, compassionate, all of that. But even more than that, closer to you than your Rahim. Your Rahim maybe at some point will give up on you. They keep coming back to you. They give you money. You go and spend them on bad things, give you a chance again, give you money, go and spend them on bad things. Give you money another time to pay your studies, go and spend them on bad things. At some point, your father will tell you, no, that's it. I can't anymore. But Ar-Rahim subhanahu wa ta'ala will keep always giving you that chance. He is Tawwab and He is Rahim. He is also, He is reaching to you, often reaching to you, often of returning to you all the time, and He is closer to you than your own self and than your relatives. At-Tawwab al-Rahim as a pair are called the key of Ma'rifatu Adam. That's the key that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's the rope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to Adam. That is that verse in the Quran, فَتَلَقَّى آدَمُ مَنْ رَبِّهِ كَلِمَاتٍ فتاب عليه إنه هو التواب الرحيم. That's where it is mentioned. So Adam, and when we say Adam, it's not just the Prophet Adam, it's us in our conditions, in our genes. Adam committed a mistake, and then فتلقى آدم من ربه كلمات, and then he was inspired a prayer. He was inspired words of prayer. And then فَتَابَ عَلَيْهِ, when he prayed with that prayer, فَتَابَ عَلَيْهِ, he has given him a chance, Allah reached to him through that inspiration of the prayer, and Adam responded to that inspiration. He prayed, he answered the call, because the prayer was an inspiration that was given to him by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. تَلَقَّى آدَمُ رَبِّي كَلِمَاتِ, like you تَتَلَقَّى الْحَبْلِ, تتلقى. Adam, he basically, literally, he caught. تلقى means to catch. تلقى آدم ربي كلمات فتاب عليه means Adam was able to catch what? This inspiration that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that inspiration, that intuition, the inspiration of tawbah, the intuition, the rise of consciousness, that the conscious voice within you when it starts talking, all of that is coming from God. That's a chance, that's an opportunity that is given to you by God. You need to catch it. تلقى آدم, he received it. He received that inspiration. He received that invitation. He received that call. He answered that call. He responded to that call. فتاب عليه. إنه هو التواب الرحيم. He answered his call and تاب عليه. He accepted him. إنه هو التواب الرحيم. التواب الرحيم. التواب الرحيم. التواب الرحيم. So we said this pair of name with the other pair that we saw a few nights ago. الفتاح العليم. These four names are called the names of Ma'rifa to Adam. These are the key of Ma'rifa. Because when we talk about the knowledge of God and the Ma'rifa of God and the intimate relationship with God, often we neglect that it is actually connected to Adam. Our initial fitra, before revelations, before prophets. All the prophets, they only came for tazkir, to remind us of that Adami potential within us. But the Adami potential is there. The first thing was Ya Fattah Ya Alim. We spoke about it, we talked about that a few nights ago. Ya Fattah Ya Alim. Adam received the fatah, an opening. وَعَلَّمَ آدَمَ الْأَسْمَاءَ كُلَّهَا. That was the fatah. ثُمَّ عَرَضَهُمْ عَلَى الْمَلَائِكَةِ وَهَكَذَا. And then the malaika, they said, سُبْحَانَكَ لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا إِلَّا مَا عَلَمْتَنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. طيب. Now, after that, the original علم was given. After that, to continue the path, يا تواب يا رحيم فتلقى آدم من ربه كلمات فتاب عليه إنه هو التواب الرحيم. علم آدم الأسماء كلها. And then, فتلقى آدم من ربه كلمات إنه هو التواب الرحيم. So let us have the dhikr together and call the name of Ya Tawwab, Ya Rahim, Ya Tawwab, Ya Rahim in these days of Tawbah. And you know, when it is the end of the month of Ramadan, there are two feelings there. Many feelings may come. This feeling of sadness, feeling also the ego will be crying because haven't really been successful the way we wanted. But also, we may feel we missed this opportunity. But so we need to remind ourselves that Allah is Tawwab. Even if we miss this opportunity, there will be another opportunity. And still, there are a few hours left. There are a few days left. There are a few nights left. It's not the end yet. Tawwab. Let us catch. Even if we're not able, even if we haven't been able to catch that rope of Tawbah for the past 28 days, still there are still 2 days remaining. Just catch it now. Catch it now and make up for the rest. Ya Tawwab, Ya Rahim, Ya Allah. يا تواب يا رحيم يا الله يا تواب يا رحيم يا الله يا تواب يا رحيم يا الله يا الله يا تواب يا رحيم
رحيم يا الله يا تواب يا رحيم يا الله يا تواب يا رحيم يا الله يا تواب يا رحيم يا الله يا رحيم يا الله يا تواب يا رحيم يا الله يا تواب يا رحيم يا الله يا تواب يا رحيم يا تواب يا رحيم يا الله يا تواب يا رحيم يا الله يا تواب يا رحيم يا الله يا تواب
Bring that image of God.
Of
the one, the leader of the caravan who comes back to you when you are lost and left alone in the wilderness. Bring that image.
Ya Tawwab, Ya Rahim, Ya Allah. Ya Tawwab, Ya Rahim, Ya Allah, ya Tawwab, ya Rahim, ya Allah, ya Tawwab, ya Rahim, ya Allah.
So Ramadan is a caravan. So maybe some people are on the 28th. Or 27th day of Ramadan, and maybe some of them, they are still on the first day. They haven't been able to really catch. So they need a tawab rahim. People who really caught the, who traveled with the caravan of Ramadan, now they are on 28th night. Oh. They are ready for Eid and Alhamdulillah. And you or me, or think about it. And it's good to think of oneself like that. Where am I? Maybe on these 27 days, I only got hunger and thirst. Maybe I haven't. Maybe I haven't. I haven't been able to fast. Or it only occurred to me to start the month of Ramadan today. Or my friends, they just pulled me to the mosque tonight. So I'm starting now. And still time, the caravan, oh. They are 28 days ahead.
28-day journey.
28 days ahead of you on this 30-day journey. There are 28 days ahead, and you are still in the beginning. Still, Tawwab. Come back and find, oh, we lost you. Hey, come. Bismillah. Inshallah, Ya Rab. Mahsubin, inshallah. Mahsubin, inshallah. Inshallah, counted in the caravan, and the Tawwab al-Rahim reaches to us. Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, he asked for a ma'ida min as-samaa, concluded this. He says, takunu lana 'eedan li awwalina wa akhirina. He said, Rabbana, anzil alayna ma'idatan min as-samaa. Rabbana, our Lord, our Rabb, our increaser, our nourisher, our developer, our caretaker, Rabbana. Anzil alayna ma'idatan min as-samaa. Give us a banquet from the heavens. You know what is that? That's the month of Ramadan. It's a banquet from heaven. Actually, in one of the prayers, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam uses this comparison. He refers to Ramadan, said, Ma'ida min as-sama. They used, Imam Ali used at the end of the month of Ramadan, said, this Al-Ma'ida saturfa. The Ma'ida that came from heavens, it's now going back to heavens. And then Allahu A'lam, when it comes back next year, are we going to be here? Yeah. But it's a banquet from heavens. Jesus' table, says Mawlana Jalaluddin Rumi. When you fast, expect that table to descend from heavens, he says, Jalaluddin Rumi. Jesus' table. The menu, what is on it, is better than samosas and soup and kebabs. Better than the broth of cabbage, he says himself. And that table, he did not only say, give us a table min as-sama from heavens. He insisted, said, تَكُونُ لَنَا عِيدًا لِأَوَّلِنَا وَآخِرِنَا. It becomes a عيد. It means that it becomes accessible and comes back. It keeps coming back. تَكُونُ لَنَا عِيدًا means and keeps coming back. Because that table that came to Sayyidina Isa, it came only one time and that's it. But the real table that keeps coming back, Eidan, is this. It's Ramadan, and that's why the last day we call it the day of Eid. This is the table. Eidan li awalina wa akhirina. What it means li awalina wa akhirina? Saghirina wa kabirina. Awalina wa akhirina, awalina, as-sabiqun as-sabiqun. Those who really were able to catch the caravan since day one. And al-mukhallafin. لقد تاب الله go back to التواب in Surah التوبة لقد تاب الله على النبي والذين آمنوا معه starts with the first السابقون الذين تابعوه في ساعة العسرة the strong ones but after that at the end وعلى الثلاثة المخلفين and the three who were left behind and actually they were left behind many days more than 20 days they were actually left behind they did not catch it at all. They were not able to catch it. The time Ka'b ibn Malik was, khalas, he was talking to his wife, I think I should go. Rasulullah came back already. Oh, 2 months. 2 months, you did not move, now you want to move. Still, tawb. Al-thalath al-mukhan. عيدا لأولنا وآخرنا. It means an opportunity for the strongest ones amongst us and the weakest ones as well. أولنا وآخرنا and even those who are running behind آخرنا. You know, in the marathon, أولنا in the marathon, they are in the beginning and those who are left behind and broken legs and stand. Even them, they are mahsoob, inshallah. عيدا لأولنا وآخرنا. For all of us. And because...